right, guys, another Patreon month.
This is a big one. So we're doing another full album of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band all the way through, front to back.
We had a lot of demand to hit the Beatles again, so yeah. Delivering.
Yeah.
And then we hit some Billy Joel, we hit Moving Out, and then we also hit Fleetwood, some Peter Green era Fleetwood Mac, Oh Well.
Yeah, so we did both parts of that. Now, those songs we're going to drop a little later in the month, but it's all going to be on Patreon for this month, just for you guys. And we might drop something special in there, too. With that being said, back to your normal video.
Hey guys, hope you're having a great day as well as a great life.
Somehow I knew you were gonna say that.
What? dude, it's time for some more Toto, dude.
Yeah, I'm really excited.
Hold the Line was a banger in its own right.
I've heard it like two or it's so weird. And I don't know if it's just the universe playing tricks on me.
Yeah.
But every time I've been out after we hear one of these songs on the channel, like literally the next day I'll be at the gym and they'll be playing that song.
That's happened to me at least three or four times.
And so I don't know if it's just now I'm recognizing them like out in public, like when I'm walking in a mall and I'm like, oh my God, that's what that background music is.
Yeah.
But who's playing Hold the Line at the gym? Like, yeah. Great on ya, but like that followed by some Steely Dan. It's like, I feel like the owner of the gym watches our videos and he's like, now I can play this song for him. it's a small gym, so I don't know, maybe.
I heard Peg at the gym like 2 weeks ago.
Dude, I did too.
I was like, what?
I don't know who's lifting weights and is like, you know what would really make me lift more weights is Peg.
I did at least 2 or 3 months ago. I played Peg while I was working out.
Really?
I don't know why. I was like, you know what? I want some Steely Dan right about
it's
now.
It's a good song. But yeah, so Toto, Rosanna, I'm freaking down.
They overwhelmingly said this had to be the next
really?
One we checked out.
Dude,
by
I'm
them.
So excited. I'm so excited. With that being said, make sure to subscribe because we are still on the road to the 80, 90, 100K. We're dropping those specials each time. We're going to be doing something special.
I'm excited for some full albums, bro. I'm excited.
Dude, a full album for each 10K. So we're going to hit that pretty, pretty darn soon, and we're going to have that for you guys. With that being said, let's get into it. I love the shuffle. I think I've seen people do drum covers of this, but I haven't heard
it. All I wanna do when I wake up in the morning is see your eyes. Rosanna, Rosanna. Never thought that a girl like you could ever care for me. Rosanna. All I wanna do in the middle of the evening is hold you tight. Rosanna, Rosanna. I didn't know you were looking for more than I could ever be. Nobody since you went away.
Unexpected.
Rosanna, yeah. Now she's gone and I have to stay. Yeah. she's gone, and I have to say,
That's how you fade out a song. We've been having a lot of great examples of fade outs this past couple
weeks. We had
some
poor examples for the first like 90% of this channel's history. Yeah. And then it's great examples after that. As soon as we're like, hey, fade outs suck, people are like, no, they're not. They're good.
Yeah, literally, they can be good.
Wow. Okay, so what I said at the very beginning of this, I just want to, because that is awesome, is so I don't play drums very well, but I love drums and I want to get better at them. So I've been looking up like drum videos on YouTube, and I was looking up some shuffle stuff, and I guess now it makes sense that I remember the name of the song was from those shuffle videos. And so the beat comes in, and I'm like, oh my God, I've literally watched like a drum tutorial on like, here's this amazing shuffle and played. I don't know who the drummer is, but obviously he's going to be super famous because he's a killer, killer drummer. And dude, that is so much better than I, like hearing the drums out of context, great. Hearing the drums out of, with context of the song, whole different thing. Whole different thing. That's so good. Just
yeah. No, you're 100% on point. I think they're great because this song, it feels like a pop song of the time, but then how do they throw in so many just like awesome elements?
Dude, it's jazzy. It's got some like weird Afro-Cuban styles. Like it's got this cool shuffle feel, this Motown feel. Like everything
it's like
about
you,
it.
You compare like modern pop to like this, you know, being pop from that time period.
It really is
complete
different.
Night and day in terms of the production styling. Because nowadays it's like, oh, you have like since, you know, Echo the Bass Lines or Echo the Chord Changes, I mean, and then, but they replace bass.
I can play it's pretty just, much any pop song that is out right now. Pretty much 99% can play any pop song.
Yeah, within like but, 10 minutes.
But it's like this is like, you have to have like a world-class drummer, a world-class bass player, a phenomenal guitarist. I don't know who the guitarist was, but world-class. I guarantee that he's got a name on a stone somewhere at some place, you know?
Yep.
And then a great singer.
No, they said in the last video we did for Hold the Line that everyone in this band, they are studio musicians or session musicians for other people, and then they kind of started making their own music too.
It sounds like it. I mean, just I'll tell you this, the level of maturity, and we I think I say that a few times on the channel, but like I feel like this is probably one of the biggest examples of that.
Yeah.
And there is just so much maturity in everything, in the dynamic range people are playing, and like the sparseness, like just no, like even what's called ghost notes, right? So when you're playing a shuffle, you're like, right, you're playing a little bit on snare, right? Very lightly, ghost notes, almost imperceivable in the
song. But
you feel it.
Yep.
And it's like, holy cow, he's playing it so precise. The bass is playing so precise. Like the guitar is one of those big wow, like those like big hits. It's so tight. The volume is so controlled, and even like the vocals when they like crescendo up like in volume during the weird halftime parts with the snaps, so beautifully done.
Yeah.
Like, masterful. Like, I'm like, how do you write that? Where you just go, okay, so we want this snap to go every 6 bars, and then every third and a half bar, we're going to put, like, third. It just,
yeah,
so good.
And I love how the guitarist, he, like, teased his sauce, teased his flavor on the halfway point, and then comes for the finisher in the end.
Yep.
He was like,
all right. I did what's right for the song. You mind if I just get a little bit in there? And they're like, yeah, you can get a little bit in there.
So you can tell he has the mastery of knowing how to write a solo that's going to hit you emotionally in these ways, and then has, like, the swagger to pull up and, like, make it, like, human at the same
time.
Yeah,
if you can play a solo like that, you're, as a guitarist, you've made it. That's it. That's all you need. Yeah. You don't need more than that. There are maybe better guitarists on paper. Somebody's more like, oh, I like this guy more than this guy. He's the best guitarist in the world. But if you can play like that and you pull up in front of anybody, even if they're the best guitarist in the world, they're going to be like, pretty fucking cool. Like, all right, all right, man.
I've got the tiniest, and it's a personal thing.
Oh, I actually do too. You go first. Yeah, yeah.
So mine's actually, it's more of a compliment, but still, like, you know, to the song. But I wish they had one more moment where they went, Rosanna, Rosanna. I wish they had one more section where they went into that, just because, like, they did it twice, and it was really so great. The first time it kind of, like, opened it up, and I was like, that's really cool. That's catchy. But it comes back, and it's like, oh, my God. I want it one more time. And then they didn't give it to me, bro. They didn't do it.
Do you want to know what mine is?
What is it?
So I play guitar at my church. I don't really do it anymore because I don't have time, but I did for a very long time play guitar at my church, and they have all these songs with Hosanna in it. And they're sung, like, exactly the same as that.
Yeah.
Like, Hosanna, Hosanna. Like, and they just sing it like that. So every time I was listening to it, I was like, these people at church just stealing in, like, the 16th century, coming over and stealing land, and now they're stealing from Toto. What are you doing? Thought that ended after the Crusades. Apparently I was wrong. They're just over here conquering land.
Stealing vocal melodies forever.
All day. Yeah, I'm like, the Lord would not be happy.
With this case. Oh, my goodness. So that's your nitpick.
It's not even on them. It was just like, it kept reminding me of church. Yeah. And I was like, it's kind of a weird thing, but all right.
Yeah. Let's check these lyrics real quick.
God, it's a freaking good song.
Lyrics have been digested.
Okay. So I love the emotional maturity, because, like, there's a lot of breakup songs that are just like, I'm really sad she left.
Yeah.
That makes
life
me upset.
Sucks.
Life sucks. But very rarely, and this is maybe, like, something that I don't know why they don't do it. Maybe it's just a personal, like, people don't do this in general.
Yeah.
But not only she left and I'm sad, but the rationale behind it, it's like, so you don't have, she left because she didn't want to have to compromise.
Yeah.
Or now at least I can take solace in that she didn't have to compromise. Like, what was the line up in the front? It was, I didn't know you were looking for more than I could ever be, which is really, really brutally truth honest to yourself. Like,
yeah.
Self-reflective at your own failings and being like, listen, I not even am I not there, like, I'm not there currently, but it's I could never be where she needs for me to be.
Yeah.
And
but then it's like accepting that, and it's like kind of like
trying
to move on from that that concept,
and being like, I'm still really sad, I still really really love this person,
but I'm always happy that she doesn't have to compromise now, like, by, you know.
Yeah, dude, which that's a really beautiful and, like, self-reflective thought. Like, that takes a lot of now musical maturity, now emotional maturity, like, to even write that, to, like, whether you've gone through this or not, the fact that he can write it down and think of a scenario where that would be the case, it shows a lot on them as people. So
that's true.
I think it's beautiful,
dude. How do we rate this song? Because I'll tell you what, okay. I had this huge rationale already made up,
sure,
you know, when the song was happening, where I was like, okay, I think I'd rather listen to this song way more than Hold the Line, 100%.
Yeah.
But I think Hold the Line is an S tier song, and that this holds right behind it at A+. But I'd rather listen to this way more, but it's still A+ versus that. I felt that strongly, but now I feel very conflicted after reading those lyrics.
I feel the opposite.
Really?
I appreciate the hell out of this song, and I really, really enjoy it. I don't know how much I'll go back and listen to it.
Really? But if you're listening to Toto, like, you think you'd listen to Hold the Line more than this song?
Maybe.
Really?
Maybe.
That, I mean,
but I think
I can see that.
But I think this is a better song in every regard.
Yeah.
I think there's nothing that the song, like, I think the level of maturity packaged in this song and the level of talent it took to not only write, perform, just the whole nine yards with it, produce, I think this took way, way more work than Hold the Line. And
100%.
And so I can appreciate that. And to me, that's an S tier, even though it's not like I might not listen to this at the same level I'll listen to other S tier songs.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I just have to give props where props is due. And it's, to me, like, if you're talking about music, like, this is an art piece. Like, this is a masterclass. Like, if you're a drummer, yeah, you should listen to this song. If you're a guitar player, listen to this song. You're a vocalist, listen to this song. Producer, like, keep going down the line, listen to this song. Because it is just going to make you better.
Inspiration, yeah.
And even if you're just a person living life and you're like, hey, you got in a breakup because that's normal because that happens in life, I want you to just read these lyrics. And they're like, shoot, I hadn't thought of it that way.
Fuck, dude.
Yeah. So to me, it's like, I think it's an S-tier song, even though it's again, it gives me those churchy vibes. So yeah, to me, I just don't know if I'll listen back to it as much.
Oh, just because
it
so
puts
true
me in a weird, I'm like, I don't want to listen to like church music when I'm not at church. Like, yeah, I know that's some people's favorite. It's just not mine.
Yeah.
But damn, I can't, dude. I can't say that it's not an S.
You literally like sold that to me. Cause I was on the fence of A, yeah, plus to S, but I think I have to go S now. Okay. I think your rationale is like spot on.
Dude, it's a great song. I'm very, very happy to listen to that.
Dude, Love and Toto.
Love and Toto. I mean, so far it's been two just phenomenal songs.
Yeah, absolutely, oh, man.
So I guess let us know what's next. That was awesome. Really excited for this week. It's going to be a killer week. If you're not subscribed, go ahead and subscribe. Hit the notification bell.
All that good stuff.
All that good stuff. Dude, let's chill out. Let's listen to some music. We got some cool stuff coming out on the way.
Absolutely.
And we'll be seeing you this week.